Okay, see, there is a picture here. Can you
yes,
see that?
ma'am.
Yes, so there is diffusion. The difference between diffusion and osmosis, here is a concentrated molecule and it tends to diffuse through the whole solution. So that is diffusion. And when it's osmosis, this is a semi-permeable membrane. And there is two types of solution. One is more, this one is more concentrated, and this one is dilute, you can say, and maybe just water. So when this is separated by a semi-permeable membrane, you can see that the water is diffusing through that membrane, and the volume here increases. So this is osmosis. Only the solvent moves. Okay. So now that we have learned about osmosis, there is something called water potential. You can remember that when solvent is less concentrated, the water potential is high. And when there is concentrated solution, the water potential is low. It is the concentration of the solvent or the water that is termed as water potential. You just remember that when osmosis happens, the diffusion takes place from a region of higher water potential to a region of lower potential, that is from a dilute solution to a concentrated solution. So remember the term water potential. And there is then plasmolysis. What happens during plasmolysis? Okay, well, during osmosis, what happens if a cell is placed in a water and the concentration of the cell is more than the water? Of course, there is some solution in the cytoplasm and that is more concentrated than water. So when that happens, when you put a cell into water, the water moves in into the cell, and ultimately for animal cell, it bursts because it gets bigger and bigger, and there is no cell wall to protect the cell. So at some point, the cell wall, cell membrane bursts, and for plant cell, what happens? There is a cell wall to protect the plant cell. So the cell becomes rigid and firm. So that is something that happens for cell, plant cell. And the plant cell is known as the turgid. Okay. There is a term called turgid. When the plant cell in a water condition becomes tight and firm. So this is called the turgid, and the turgidity of the cell helps the plant with no wood in it to stay upright and keep the leaves firm. So that is something happens with plant cell that doesn't happen with animal cell. I can show you another picture here. Okay. And then there comes plasmolysis. Plasmolysis happens when there is the reverse condition. That is when you put a cell in a more concentrated solution. So then what happens to the cell? I am sharing this screen here. Okay, see, there is a picture of animal cell in upper part and plant cell in lower part. So hypotonic solution means the outer solution is less concentrated. Hypo means less. So the concentration of the solution outside of the cell is less. So what happens to the cells? For animal cells, it lysed. That is, it bursts open. So that is lysis. The cell destroys. And for plant cell, it becomes turgid, as I told you. So now isotonic solution means
what is the meaning of turgid?
Tell me again. Targit. Okay, I just told you what is targit. When for a plant cell, when you put that plant cell into like water or less diluted solution, lesser than the cell concentration, the cell becomes firm. It doesn't burst like animal cells because it has cell wall around it. So it becomes firm and tight. So that is called turgid. So when that happens, you can say that cell is in turgid, or the turgidity of the cell is that. And then there is isotonic solution. Isotonic means the same concentration that is inside the cell and outside the cell. That is the concentration, no difference in the concentration. So the cell remains as it is. It is called flaccid because for animal cell, this is normal condition. And you can say that it is flaccid in, I mean, for plant cell, the terms are changed. It is flaccid for isotonic solution, and then hypertonic solution, that is the concentration outside the cell is more than inside the cell. What happens? That the animal cell shriveled, that is, that shrinks. Because water is coming out of the cell. Because the concentration is higher in outside, so the water will try to get outside the cell. That is, the osmosis happening here. And the water will shrink, the cell, the animal cell will shrink. And for plant cell, what happens? The when the water is coming out of the cell, there is cell wall present. So that cannot shrink because cell wall is firm and gives the rigidity of the cell. So the cytoplasm or the cell membrane ultimately tears from the cell. Tears and shrink, try to shrink. That is plasmolyzed. So the plant cell gets plasmolyzed when that is put in a hypertonic solution or the more concentrated solution. So that is the case here. And you have to remember these terms, turgidity and your plasmolysis. So what happens when? Then there is active transport. See, for osmosis, when you put something, so when you put a cell of more concentration in a less concentrated solution, osmosis happens. The water or the less concentrated solution gets into the cell. But when plasmolysis happens, that is the concentration of water or the concentration of the cell is lesser than the outside concentration. So that is when plasmolysis happens, the cells become plasmolyzed and the water goes outside the cell. But sometimes it happens that the concentration of say a solute or an ion is less in the soil. Suppose you are thinking about a cell, about a root hair present in the root, and it needs to take up some ions which is much less in concentration in soil. So when that takes up, ultimately the concentration of that ion becomes more in the cell itself, but the concentration of the ion is much less in soil. And so what it does, it have to transport that ions. It cannot let the ions get into the soil again from the cell. So what happens? There is some mechanism called active transport. Active transport is when there is concentration, the outside concentration is less, but the inside concentration is more. But still it needs to take up that small concentrated thing into the cell, and it has to transport that into the stems or leaves. So what happens? They put some energy into it to take up that ion or take up that molecule. So that is active transport happening there. And how do they do that? That they put some energy, and the energy is provided by the respiration. The respiration happens within the cell in the mitochondria where energy is produced by ATP. So they put that ATP into that membrane. There is some transport protein or carrier protein. The ATP change their structure so that they can take up the small molecules, small concentrated molecules from the outside to the inside of the cell. Maybe I can show you some picture. See, there is a picture in your in page number 35. You can see that there is transport protein, the round thing, and there is glucose molecule, and that is cell membrane here labeled. So when active transport happens, glucose molecule goes into that protein, transport protein, and the shape, see, for 1 and 2, the shape changes. And ultimately in shape 3, the protein opens inside the cell and the glucose gets inside the cell. That is the opposite of your concentration gradient. So when osmosis happens, that happens too from, tell me, when osmosis happens, what happens? The concentration gradient from lower or higher, or higher or to lower?
Lower concentration to higher concentration.
Yes, but for this active transport to happen, there is
higher concentration to lower concentration.
Yes.
For active transport.
Yeah, for active transport, the concentration of solute is lower, but the molecule is that the plant takes, that is lower in the soil, and it needs to take that into inside the cell where the concentration might be higher. So that happens during the active transport. So they become, see, there is another picture I think I can show you. That is a very important, because you have to read it I think later in another chapter, how the transports happen. I'm sharing the screen again. You see, there is a picture of it. See, that is concentration of sodium is higher in this region, and concentration of sodium is lower inside the cell, that is cytoplasm, and that is extracellular phase. So if they want to transport it, they cannot diffuse through it because the concentration is lower. Suppose for sodium, that is the some sodium molecules here. And see, the sodium molecules, as this is less in cytoplasm and more in extracellular phase, diffusion cannot happen. If diffusion happens, then the sodium ions will get inside the cell. But the cell needs to transport it outside the cell. So what happens here, ATP molecule is attaching with this carrier protein or the transport protein. So attaching it, and they just change their shape. They just open here, and the sodium is released into this extracellular space. Okay, for potassium, that is something also happening here. See, there is concentration of potassium is more in the cell here in cytoplasm, and there is less potassium in the extracellular phase or outside the cell. So if they want to take up the potassium down the concentration gradient, there is higher, so they will not diffuse through the membrane. So the potassium goes into this protein carrier protein, and ATP attaches with it, and the shape is changed. Then the potassium ions are released into the cytoplasm. So that is two example actually, but this happens in cells, and this is the active transport. So anyone have any questions?
No, ma'am.
So See, there is this you have to learn detail in detail, I think, in later chapters. That's it. That is, you have to know about osmosis, diffusion, plasmolysis, and what is turgid cell, what is flaccid cell, and how the active transport happens. Okay, just these things. So this is the end of this chapter. We'll discuss the questions here, and after that, I will give you the broad question for the three chapters.
Next day, we'll discuss that end of the chapter.